Yep.
There he is. There he is. Kenny Chesney, everybody. There he is. Look at this guy. Look at this guy. What up, buddy? You good?
I'm good.
Yeah, look
at you. I can hear you. What's up?
Look at you. Always looking good.
I am?
Yeah.
You're not as good as you on the front of this magazine.
Oh, come on.
He fell for it.
Come on. Come on.
Good to see everybody.
Yeah, good to see you too. I have a lot of questions for you. I always have a lot of questions.
Hopefully I have a lot of answers.
Well, I'm going to tell you what happened. I was sitting with Liz Rose, writer extraordinaire, friend of mine. She wrote she's in the Love Junkies, wrote Girl Crush.
Yeah.
She was talking about this song here. I'm going to play some of it because you have it here. You know it. You sing it, called Better Boat. You familiar with this song?
And then I let it go. I ride the waves I can't control. I'm learning how to build a better boat.
Wasn't this the song?
Yeah, Liz wrote this song.
She wrote it like 6 or 7 years ago.
Yeah. And I've had it. Renee Bell sent this song to me a couple years ago, and I've always loved it, but it never really, I was thinking about putting that song on the Big Revival album, and it just didn't fit with the whole record. And when the storms happened in the Virgin Islands, my brain shifted to another way of creating. And so I went into the studio to make what is now the album Songs for the Saints. And I came across this song, and I knew that it was time for a song like this for me to record it, and I'm really happy I did. And it's she wrote an amazing song.
Listen to this.
What's still hurting? All the things I feel like cussing out. Now and then I let it go. Ride the waves I can't control. I'm learning how to build a better boat.
That's Mindy Smith singing with me. She's so good. So,
when you tell the story of why you picked the song, now I get it. And when she was telling the story, you know, obviously she doesn't come from the perspective of you and why you picked these songs. But I was talking to her about songs that had been on hold for a long time. She said, yeah, Kenny had that song on hold for like 6 or 7 years. Or she had written it 6 or 7 years ago.
Yeah. When I first heard it, I realized that I can't speak for the songwriters of the song as to where it came from, but when you listen to that song, you assume that it's about a past relationship or something that made you do a self evaluation, you know, and to find this inner peace in yourself. So it's a very personal song, but if you think about what happened in a broader scope down in the Virgin Islands 9 months ago. A lot of the same emotions exist, you know, they're all displaced, and there's a lot of things they want to cuss out, like the song says, and there's a lot of things that where they just have to somehow put it in God's hands and ride the waves you can't control. And all you can do is make yourself better and learn how to build a better boat. And I felt like that was such a true an emotion of how a lot of people were feeling down there. And one of the threads, a true thread of hope that goes through a big part of this record.
Kenny Chesney's here. Album is out. It's called Songs for the Saints, and you are donating the proceeds to back to the island, right?
Yes.
So how does that conversation come along where you go, all right, to whomever your people are, like, hey, we're doing this record, but the money's going back?
Yeah, like it was a pretty easy conversation to have. You know, As you know, I switched record labels, and this is my first record with John Esposito and Warner. And they knew this was coming, you know, and they knew that they could see in my eyes and in my heart how much it meant to me, and it meant a lot to them. And honestly, it was they welcomed this record with open arms. But it is unique to say that you're going to give every cent of the money of your record to a certain foundation to help rebuild the infrastructure of, you know, the Virgin Islands. But I felt in a way that it was just, you know, it's been so much a big part of my life and has fed me creatively throughout the years. And it's just, you know, I wanted to help those people so much. And this was one of the ways that I could do it is through music, because I believe music is the most healing thing we all have in our lives. And I just felt that this record was supposed to do that. And that's why all the money's going to it.
Look at you. Songs for the Saints out today. you know, I was reading this story. Every time you play a show, you set a record or something. You know, most people drinking a beer at the same time. Most people in a stadium. Most people, you know, you break it. So I was reading that thinking, I think it was Philly. There were like 50-something thousand people at your show. Yeah. Is there a difference, this is what I wonder, between 38,000 and 51,000 when you're playing a show and how you would play it? Like, just sonically, the sounds, all the things.
There's not a difference in how we would play it or how we would present it.
Like, you have to play it bigger.
We just go up there and play, you know, and hit them as hard as we can possibly hit them. And this summer, Bobby has been so special. It's hard to describe why, but the connection with the audience is very unique, and it's been built over the years. But for some reason, this year's show has been so energetic. We've changed around certain things in the way we present the show, but you know, even the stadium shows have been very good, but even the amphitheater shows and some things that aren't as big as the stadium, like what you were talking about in Philadelphia, it's just the connection has been incredible, and it's been a very special summer so far. And we did our first West Coast run last week, and it's gone by so quickly. All of a sudden, we're halfway done with the tour. You know, we play in Nashville August 11th, and then we go, I believe, to MetLife Stadium in New York, and then we close out with two nights in Boston, and that will be here before you know it. You know, when you're this busy, it goes by really quickly. But I think the answer to your question is no, we don't change the way we do for 31,000 or 11,000.
But does it feel different?
Oh, well, of course. I mean, 11, you know, yes. I mean, the more people in there, the energy that comes through your chest.
Does it feel, can you feel the when they're screaming?
Yeah,
you can feel
man.
That.
It's one of the most unbelievable experiences of my life. You know, it's a blessing and a curse because you crave it. You know, once you feel that.
And you're always chasing it again.
And
huh?
It's a high you can't get unless you're there, unless you're in that moment with a band. And people ask me all the time, what does it feel like to be up there on stage? And I can't explain it to them. You know, it's the most unbelievable feeling to feel that much energy be directed right where you're standing. You know, and so it's a love that's hard to describe, and we try to give it back. But it's you know, music is very powerful. It really is. I say it all the time. But to see how much fun these people are having and how much they care about the music, and you know, we all have, I think about this a lot too, Bobby. We all have different options we can do with our everyday lives. We can go see whatever show we want to go see. We can go to the movies. We can go to games, whatever. And they choose to come see us, which is, we don't take for granted, because we realize that those fans that are out there, it's a big investment in their life, especially a stadium show, to come be in that moment with us. Just the getting there is an investment, you know. But when you look out there and realize all that and see just how much they want to be there and how happy they are, it makes you want to give them everything you possibly have. It really does.
You're playing one of these shows, and you think to yourself, you know what? I want to play the set list. I want to play Big Star. Can you call that?
Yes.
On a show that big?
Yes.
You can get on the mic and go, hey, guys, it's Kenny here.
I have what's called a 911 mic. I have a button I can step on right in front of the drum kit, and nobody can hear it but the band and the crew, so that everybody's just in tune. And, like, we have our show's about 2 hours this year, but we've got about six or seven songs that we rehearsed a lot, and we have the light show written to, and might have some video content to it or whatever, that are just sitting there. And I can say, okay, we're not going to do...
Talk to me right now. I get the ears on. All right.
I don't want to do Out Last Night. Let's skip it. We're going to throw in Big Star. We're going to throw in Everybody Wants to Go to Heaven. Or we're going to throw in When the Sun Goes Down or whatever. You know, and so it just depends. It's just one of the things I've caught myself doing this year, and that's taking out of a lot of the ballads. So we're just hitting them really hard. It's not that I don't want to do You in Tequila. It's just that I don't want to slow it down. And I feel very blessed to be in that position to have four or five songs that I can throw in a couple of those spots. where I never want to let the energy die. So I do make those audibles a lot. And it just depends, though. It just depends on each night's different.
Because I go up on the mic for me, and I'd be like, everybody take a break. I'm going to do a... I'm gonna do a little.
Take a break.
Yeah. I'm gonna have the man take a break because I'm gonna do just me a song.
Yeah.
I'm gonna run solo here.
Yeah.
I'm gonna do slow dancing in a burning room. Everybody, you guys, sit down for a minute. You ever do that? And just like, I'm gonna do one acoustic here.
Every now and then. Yeah. I'll do Old Blue Chair by myself, or I'll do. I don't know. I've done that. I've done Wyatt, my piano player, and I. We will do There Goes My Life, just with me, a guitar, and him on piano. We would do, there's several of those songs. I had a song on the No Shoes record called Coast to Somewhere Beautiful. And sometimes we would do that song.
You ever fake it though? Like, cause I would, like in these big songs, what I do is I turn my guitar off. If like the hard songs, if I was going to dance a lot, I turn my guitar off and I fake like I'm playing and I dance all the time. But, you know, they can't tell.
No, I don't fake playing. Now, I will tell you, I'm not the best guitar player in the world. You know, it's not the thing I came to town to do. That's why I have Kenny Greenberg, and that's why I have Clayton. That's why I have John. These guys are great.
Do you ever dance?
Not really. I mean, but when I listen to music and when I hear music, especially on stage, I just move.
Oh, you move.
I can't help it. You know, my grandmother has video footage of me in her kitchen as a child, listening to music and dancing. And I saw it several years ago, and I went, wow, I move like that today. Like, I see video footage of us on stage, and now I hear my band behind me, and the drummer that I have, you know, hit me in the back with all this energy. I kind of make the same moves, ironically enough.
That's cute.
Later.
Let me hear this one here. We know this one.
We say we can when they say
Song for the Saints.
Yeah.
And you wrote this song too, huh?
I wrote this song the day after Hurricane Irma hit with Tom Douglas and Scooter Caruso. And I was just talking with them about, you know, my feelings and my emotions and all the people down there that have this resiliency and what I wanted to say to them, because it was such a time of chaos and such a time of anxiety and uncertainty in their lives and in my life, honestly. But I thought about all the people that I'd met there, how strong they are, and how I know that with a lot of people's help, they'll bounce back. And that's the core of Song for the Saints, you know, but we're just all just a sinner's choir singing a song for the saints. And that's all we had of the song, and we just kind of worked around it.
Come on, when you say it like that, I feel it. Did you know you had that idea? Like, you go, okay, we got this idea. Let's run. Like, this is a good one.
Yeah, we had those two lines, and then I thought, what do we really want to say to people, you know? And people are going, what are the saints? What are the song for the saints? Well, it's all the people that live in St. Croix and St. Bart's and St. John and St. Thomas and a lot of the BVIs that I spend a lot of time in my life, you know, that have fed me, like I said a few minutes ago, that have just fed my creativity over the years and fed my songwriting and that's went into the studio. But it was the initial relationships that did that, you know, over the years. And it, Bobby, I tell you, it was just really strange after the storm happened. And once FEMA would let us land in St. Thomas, I landed and got into a helicopter and just flew around the islands. And I'd never seen that much destruction at once in my life. I wasn't prepared. I knew it was going to be bad, but I wasn't prepared for how bad it was going to be. And that's where a lot of these songs came from, because I knew that a lot of people that I loved and had lived a lot of life with was living in a beautiful, broken place that was really broken. You know, that was living in a beautiful place that was really broken. Sorry, that's how I meant to say that. But it was just a strange way to create. You know, and this album is so different for me because, you know, when you make any record, you make it like looking back. You're reflecting on songs. You're reflecting on relationships. You're reflecting on life experiences. I made this whole album in a three-week period during Hurricane Irma and Hurricane Maria, as I had friends flying to my house to stay in my house because they had nowhere else to go. And it was really a strange time. It was full of anxiety, and there's a certain angst that I went to the studio with every day to make this record. And I think you can hear that in the way we recorded these songs. It was unlike any record I've ever made. It was really really strange to create with that much. I don't know. I guess people create with anxiety with their hearts broken and they go and just make a record. But my heart was broken in a different way. My heart was broken for a place and a people. And we were all just kind of living in the middle of that. So I didn't really have time to think. I just went into the studio and went to work making this music, not knowing really what I was getting. And this is the result. Song for the Saints.
Songs for the Saints. Yeah, you wrote this one too here. This is called We're All Here.
We're all here, because where else would we go when the world tips sideways? It's just where we rode, where that crazy...
You know, whenever you set up the context of these songs and where your mind was, and even where your body was as you're doing these songs, you listen to them differently. Like, I've heard these songs, but after you go, hey, this is where my mind was, this is where my body was, this is what was happening around me as we were doing the record, I hear them all differently. I think it's important to get that story out there.
Oh, it's important. Yeah. It is. Yeah. You know, and, you know, these songs are so personal, and they're just a looking through the window of my soul at the time. And sorry, I'm a little scratchy from the weekend singing, but yeah, Bob, that's true. I mean, I've put so much of myself into these songs, and that song there, it was a slogan that I had seen throughout the years in the islands. You know, it says we're all here because we're not all there. And it was initially about my island family because they came from different places all over the world. And all of a sudden, you know, 15 years ago, there was this group of friends that I couldn't believe that I had. I would get off the road and then I would go hang out with these group of friends that didn't care what I did, didn't know who I was to begin with. And I lived a lot of life with those people for years. But there was all something a little strange about each one of them. And I think that's why we all got along so well. But if you think about it, that's my band. It's my crew. We're all here because we're all in the music business doing what we do because we're all just a little bit left of center in the first place to even want to be there in the first place. But when I think about it in a much broader scope, it's my audience. It's those people I see out there every night that's there because maybe they're just we're all here because we're not all there. And I think about that a lot because it's such an eclectic group of people that have one thing in common. They just love music and love the idea of being there. And that's what we had in mind. I wrote that song with Casey Beathard and David Lee Murphy. But we kept all those people in mind about how, you know, we going through our everyday life, how we might have a screw too loose on one side and a screw too tight on the other. And we got to figure it all out in the middle.
Look at this. Got the new record out today. Songs for the Saints. Looking fit. You're right in mode,
Thank
huh?
It, man.
Like you're right in mode.
Oh, yeah, I'm in show mode now. Doing our show three times a week will make you lean down a little bit.
And no carbs after what? Or
oh,
you
good
say
memory.
You don't eat after 5?
I do eat after 5, but I don't eat carbohydrates.
No carbs after 5.
Yeah.
I thought about that since you said it.
Thank you, man.
You look
trying.
Good.
I got to get in fight and shape to do these shows, so. We've been working hard. Daniel, my trainer's been doing a good job. I have a love-hate relationship with him.
You know. I get it. I get it. Well, listen, everybody, check out the record, buy it, stream it, you know, and know that all the money that it goes to this is not going to Kenny. It's actually going back to something Kenny
loves. It's helping
loves
to build schools. It's helping to build hospitals. It's helping to send instruments, it's getting dogs off the island, it's doing so much stuff. So it's just rebuilding the infrastructure on any level you can think of.
Look at you. Look at this guy. Also, big shout out for this one.
Let's say everything's gonna be.
Come on, number one.
David Lee Murphy, number one. I can't believe it. It's one of my favorite records I've ever been a part of. And I'm so happy for him.
Me too.
So good.
I'm so happy for him. You know, and the fact that it did as good as it that it's done. You know, we're up there on stage singing this song, and to see the sea of people sing this one common emotion, and everybody's going through stuff in their life. We all walk around with negativity and baggage and weight and stuff. I think this song I think that's one of the reasons that this song did as well as it did, because for 3 minutes they're reminded that, you know, sometimes things aren't as bad as they seem. And so that's why I was very proud of that song. And man, I'm glad I sang on that record. We'll be doing that song on our own show forever.
Yeah. Here's this one too, obviously. This one just smashed. Here we go. Get along.
This one too. We'll be doing this one for a while.
Well, my friend, it's good to see you. Congratulations.
Man, thank you for everything. Good to see you. And I love you guys. Thanks for having me in.
Kenny Chesney got the record out today. And until next time,
hopefully it's soon.
Hopefully it is soon. There he is, our friend Kenny Chesney, everybody. And we'll be back in 1 second. Got the new record out today.